Welcome to ninth video of Analog Electronics Lab. So in this video we shall see how do we interface IR sensor to Arduino board to control the light or the motor. Now we know that here we are asked to write an Arduino script to sense the signal from an IR sensor and turn on the motor if it senses any movement. So the sensor is a infrared sensor, the actuator is a DC motor. And the task is to rotate the DC motor when the object is detected. So we know that the infrared will actually give a logic 1 whenever it detects an object. So implementation is done using the Arduino board. The output of the sensor, the output signal from the IR sensor is logic 0, that is 0 volt when there is no object in front of that IR sensor. If there is an object in front of the IR sensor, we'll get a logic 1, that is 5 volt. If the object is if you find any object that is detected by that IR sensor, we want to get a 5 volt. So it will be a constant 5 volt or 0 volt. The Arduino reads the digital signal and should give a digital signal to rotate the motor. So this is the task we are supposed to execute. So this is the Arduino board. We are not supposed to use any of the analog input, because the input to that Arduino board is also a digital, the output is also digital. So we may use a L293D to drive a motor. Okay, these are the specifications of the 293D IC, and this is the connection what you can think of doing. So this is the IR sensor module, which is going to have a IR transmitting and receiving diodes. So this is the plus 5 volt ground and the output. Since output is digital, it is connected to a digital input pin, and the output is again a digital, so which will be taken out from the Arduino and given to L293D to drive a motor. Now I can see pin number just a minute. So pin number 8 is connected to 12 volt, because we are driving a 12 volt motor. Now you can see motor is directly connected to pin number 3, the output of the buffer, so that motor runs whenever there is a logic 1 on this input. So we have to write a script so that whenever it detects a high here, so they should enable, they should give a high over here. Now this is the script. Now we are reading a digital read as well as a digital write. So we are writing, we are assigning IR as 3 and motor as 13. So you are initializing pin number 3 as input, which is IR here, because we named it as IR because it is, the signal is coming from an IR sensor. The output is going to a motor, so through the driver IC, that's why the output is named as 13, that is motor. So this motor comma output and IR comma input. So these are the two mode definitions we are supposed to do. And now we are looking for the, if digital read IR is double equals high, meaning if the red value, digital red value from the IR sensor is high, we are supposed to make the motor high. That is, the high value will be floating on pin number 13, so we'll be making the motor pin, that is pin number 13, as high if the detected value is high. If the detected value is not high, so you are putting low on the motor pin, that is pin number 13. So pin number 13 is made high or low depending on whether the IR signal is red, high or low. If the statement is true here, if the statement is true, we want to make this motor high. The statement is false, the motor pin is made low, so that motor is off. That's a very simple thing, no need of using any relay here, because you can directly drive the motor. So this is one of the simplest way of driving a DC motor from an IR sensor. So if you are asked to drive an AC motor, now this can be connected to a relay coil. Now this can be connected to real relay coil, and that the NVO, MC and the common are appropriately connected to the motor, so that the motor rotates depending on the signal that is available on the input. Now whether the relay energizes or not, depending on that, the motor will run. that's the easiest way of doing the experiment. Now we shall see one more experiment where we are asked to write an Arduino stick processor signal from the IR sensor and turn on the bulb for 10 seconds if there is any movement detected in the corridor. So the sensor is a IR sensor, which is a proximity infrared sensor. The actuator is a bulb, and the task is to turn on the bulb on detection of any object for 10 seconds. So we are supposed to make the bulb on for 10 seconds whenever there is an object detected. The implementation is again using the Arduino board. So here you can see the IR sensor. It generated pulse of specified width on detection of an object near the PIR sensor. So whenever the object is detected near the PIR sensor, it will be generating a pulse of specified duration. And the Arduino should give a logic 1 for 10 seconds on detection of the pulse from the PIR sensor. So this is what we are supposed to do. So PIR sensor gives a pulse, so on the detection of an object. So once a pulse is given, the Arduino should give a logic 1 for 10 seconds so that bulb is on. So this is the Arduino board. So again we are looking at a pulse which is connected to a digital input, and an output is taken from the digital output so that you can rotate the you can make the bulb turned on. Now this is a driver IC which will be connected to relay so that relay turns on the bulb. So this we already know what is the pin functions of L293D. Now as you can see, now the PIR sensor will give only one pulse if it is detected. The suppose there is an object in front of it for a very small very fraction of duration. Assume that there is an object which is always standing, it is always near that PIR sensor, then it is keep on giving the pulses at a repeated interval. So if there is no object present near the PIR sensor, it will be a zero. So meaning that if there is any object comes close to this, you'll get a pulse. If there is any object which is there present permanently, it will keep giving the pulses. Now this is a digital signal that is high or low, that will be sensed by this Arduino board, and you can give this to a transistor or a driver IC so that it can turn on the bulb. This is the bulb connection, how we can make it. So we can connect this to one end of the broken line wire to NO, the other end can be connected to common. When current flows through this, the bulb turns on. When the current is not flowing through this, it is in off condition. Now this is, you can see now, this is not pin number 13, this is actually pin number 7. So pin number 7 is taken as the output. Pin number 3, this is here, that is pin number, actually this is 4 here. So this is pin number 4, so this should be, the digital pin 4 is used as input. So this pin number 7 is used as, this is again not the motor, so this can be, so there is a bug in this. So if you copy this and paste it, you won't get it properly, because this is motor, this is bulb, so there is a mismatch. To make sure that you are not doing any such mistakes while writing the code, so this is intentionally done so that you are not copying any code which is there on the presentation. So you should be able to identify the bug and try to fix it. So this is a pin mode. One is output, other is input. Input is actually sensing the PIR. The output is to turn on the bulb. So you can see digital read PIR if it is double equals to high. That is, if there is any detection of a pulse from the PIR. So your, if this statement is true, you are digitally writing a high onto the bulb for 10 seconds. So this 10,000 corresponds to 10 seconds. We know that 1,000 corresponds to 1 second. So naturally 10,000 corresponds to 10 seconds. Meaning if the digital read PIR is equal to high, so we are supposed to make a high on the bulb pin so that the bulb turns on. If this PIR sensor output is zero, so there is no need to turn on the bulb. So meaning that if there is any movement on the corridor, the PIR detects a pulse, PIR detects that movement and it gives a pulse. So once it detects a pulse, so it should, the Arduino should give a pulse of high for 10 seconds and after 10 seconds, if there is no more movement happening, the bulb will go low, or bulb will turn up. Suppose assume that the object is, you keep having the movement for longer time. So after 10 seconds, it will again energize, it will make the bulb on for a longer time. This way you can turn on, turn off the bulbs depending on the PIR sensor output. Okay, I wish all of you all the best in the coming examinations.